I don't write very much. I just bullshit. That's what I do. I've always been a bullshitter. I didn't realise at the time that's what you needed to be in the music business. It's a secret. So anyway, I managed to bullshit a deal for this band, the Pink Floyd. The Pink Floyd was started through being all underground and avant-garde. We did the UFO, the London Free School, we did this UFO club. And it was the underground. It was, we hit the zeitgeist. Now, if you don't know what the zeitgeist is, look it up when you get home. It's a key word. The zeitgeist is what you need to be if you're in the music business. You need to hit the zeitgeist. We hit the zeitgeist. We made the zeitgeist. Everybody ran around with bells hanging from their necks and wearing Afghan coats and smoking dope and wearing necklaces. This was the underground. Welcome to 1966. And it exploded. It went huge. Everybody wanted to sign the band. We started in September. By the end of the year, we were fated in several magazines as the band of the next year. The next year, the record company put out a record, Straight to Heaven in 67. And we did, that was See Emily Play. And we did this big concert, which was the first concert in the Queen Elizabeth Hall. So we kind of did, it took off. I don't know what happened or why, we just hit the right time with the right stuff, and the key person was Sid Barrett. And Sid Barrett was a genius, and he was wonderful, and he created the Pink Floyd. If you want to know why the Pink Floyd were a great band, it's because of Sid Barrett's creativity. All I did, my partner, we encouraged him to write. We encouraged them to use their songs. We encouraged them to do their thing. We encouraged them all to, and we inflicted on them, lights. We built our own light show for them. Let me tell you, I am not an electrician. I don't know how we didn't manage to burn anywhere down. The lighting we used was domestic lights with switches, you know, like in your house. And we had the lights very close because they were all fixed spotlights. So very close to the band, the poor band got roasted. But the result was we had a screen behind us and there were these fantastic shadows going on. So that was a light show. Then we also had the lights came over from San Francisco with the blippy bloop, bloop, bloop lights. So that was it, and welcome to the underground. And that was how the Floyd started. Unfortunately, Sid then went crazy in the course of time for whatever reasons. I think, you know, we can talk about that at another time. And we went on, the band went on. I made the great business decision, which shows what a great businessman I was. I decided to stay with Sid because he was the genius. He was the lead guitar player, wrote the songs, and the lead singer. And the band said to me, the rest of them, you don't think we can do it without Sid, do you? So I, with my great perception, said, no, I don't. So I made this great decision. I went out with Sid. We made some records together subsequently, where by that I mean I went into the studio and Sid tried or didn't try or whatever, and we made some sort of records, some of which some people particularly like in a strange way. There's something mysteriously wonderful about them, but it was pretty damn mysterious for me. Let me tell you, I had no idea what was going on. You know, all I knew was it was very underground. But in the light of all that, I learned a lot about the music business. I started signing other bands. I became involved with EMI. Freddie Cannon's here, he'll tell you all about that. And we went on from there, and I did the concerts in Hyde Park because I could. And since then, I've become very involved in doing things which are about the position of the musicians in the music industry. And I'm fighting and have always fought for the deals for the creators. And I just want to leave by saying that I think in the current climate with the digitization, we have to have new and different copyright. It doesn't work. We have to find a way to deal with streaming so that the creators get paid. If we have a music business where the creators don't get paid, we will get not very good music. And let me tell you that that is the key issue, is can we rewrite the structure of the business, of the music business, so that the money gets to the people who create the music, not just the people who sit in the private jets. And with that extraordinary left-wing rant, I will love you and leave you.